Semi-solid cloning with ClonaCell media provides an efficient method for simultaneous selection and cloning of mammalian cell lines. During semi-solid cloning, freshly fused or transfected cells are immobilized within a viscous medium. This allows individual cells to grow into discrete monoclonal colonies. Picking these colonies enables isolation of clones with a high probability of monoclonality in a single cloning step. During this process, both slow and fast-growing clones form discrete colonies, which can be isolated and expanded separately. This makes it easy to isolate diverse clones, thus increasing the probability of isolating rare, high-yielding clones. Semi-solid cloning with ClonaCell media makes it easy to isolate a large number of diverse clones with a high probability of monoclonality, while using fewer resources than other methods, such as limiting dilution cloning. ClonaCell FLEX semi-solid base medium is designed for cloning a wide variety of cell types. By adding a 2x concentrate of your own liquid cell culture media, you can create a semi-solid cloning medium that is customized to your own cells and processes. This video describes the semi-solid cloning protocol using ClonaCell FLEX semi-solid base medium. This protocol involves introducing the gene of interest and preparing the cells for cloning, preparing the semi-solid medium and adding supplements and selection agents, adding the cells to the supplemented semi-solid medium, plating the semi-solid cell suspension into culture dishes, incubation of the plated cultures, picking the colonies and transferring them to liquid medium for expansion, preparation of cells for cloning. ClonaCell FLEX can be used to clone a variety of cell types, including CHO cells and hybridomas. These cells can be prepared using a variety of methods, after which ClonaCell FLEX can be used for selection and cloning. Introduce your gene of interest or otherwise prepare your cells for cloning using your normal protocol. Depending on the cell type, cells may require an appropriate incubation period prior to selection and cloning. On the day before you plan to plate the cells for semi-solid cloning, remove the 45 ml bottle of ClonaCell FLEX from the freezer and thaw at 4 degrees Celsius overnight. The thawed medium will be required the next day. Preparation of semi-solid medium and addition of supplements and selection agents. On the day following transfection, you will need to prepare the semi-solid medium by adding a 2x liquid growth medium concentrate, selection agents, and any other supplements. You will then add the cells and dispense the semi-solid cell suspension into 10 cm dishes for incubation. 45 ml of ClonaCell FLEX semi-solid base medium is provided in each bottle. 45 ml of a 2x concentrated solution of your own liquid cell culture medium and a liquid additive solution containing selection agents and any other supplements are added to the bottle, followed by the cells to be cloned. After adding these components, the total volume of semi-solid cell suspension will be 100 ml. As we move through the following steps, it's important to remember that the total volume of the liquid additive solution and the liquid cell suspension should not exceed 10 ml. To prepare the semi-solid medium, first remove the 45 ml bottle from the refrigerator. Place the bottle in an incubator at 37 degrees Celsius and pre-warm the medium. Add 45 ml of your 2x concentrated liquid cell culture medium. This medium should be specific to the cell type and selection system you're using. Your bottle should now contain 90 ml of semi-solid medium, leaving a total volume of 10 ml for additives and cells to be added. Calculate the amount of selection agents and supplements to be added to the medium. You can use the same concentration of these components as you would when cloning in liquid medium. Remember, the total volume of the liquid additive solution and the cell suspension added to the bottle should be 10 ml. In this video, we add 5 ml of liquid additive solution and 5 ml of cell suspension. Prepare the liquid additive solution by adding your supplements and selection agents to a 1x solution of your liquid medium. add 5 milliliters of the liquid additive solution to the bottle of semi-solid medium. Your bottle should now contain 95 milliliters of supplemented semi-solid medium. Shake the bottle vigorously to mix the medium. If you do not need the whole bottle of semi-solid medium for your experiment, unneeded medium can be aliquoted and frozen for future use. This should be done prior to adding the cells. To prepare the cells for semi-solid cloning, remove the cells from the incubator. Cells can either be harvested by centrifugation or transferred directly from the culture flask. Regardless of which method is used, they must be in a single cell suspension. Perform a viable cell count. Calculate the number of cells to plate. Plating at various cell densities is recommended to achieve 50 to 200 colonies per 100 millimeter dish. The plating cell concentration will need to be determined experimentally, as it will vary depending on the cell type, transfection efficiency, the condition of the cells, etc. Add the calculated volume of cells to an appropriate volume of 1x liquid cell culture medium. You should now have a total volume of 5 milliliters of cell suspension that is to be added to the bottle. Add the 5 milliliters of liquid cell suspension to the 95 milliliters of supplemented semi-solid medium in the bottle. Mix thoroughly and let sit for at least 15 minutes to allow the bubbles to rise to the top. The cells are now ready for plating. Aseptically plate 9.5 milliliters of the semi-solid cell suspension into 100 millimeter dishes. Use a 12 milliliter syringe with 16 gauge blunt end needle. Tilt and rotate each dish to ensure that the semi-solid cell suspension is evenly distributed over the dish. The covered 100 millimeter dishes may be placed inside a larger dish with an uncovered 100 millimeter dish containing sterile water. This will help to keep the cultures well humidified. Place the cover on the large dish and incubate the plates at 37 degrees Celsius and 5% carbon dioxide for 10 to 14 days. It's important that the cultures are not disturbed during this incubation period. Harvesting. After 10 to 14 days of undisturbed incubation, individually suspended cells will have grown into discrete colonies in the semi-solid medium. The colonies then need to be transferred to individual wells of a 96-well plate for expansion in liquid medium. Prepare the 96-well plates by adding 200 microliters of liquid cell culture medium to each well. Ensure that the liquid cell culture medium you use contains any additives needed for growth and expansion of your cells. Set a pipette to 10 microliters. Using a new sterile pipette tip for each colony, aspirate the colonies individually. Transfer each colony to the liquid medium in a new well of a 96-well plate. Colonies of different sizes should be selected. Slower growing clones may produce high levels of the desired product. Gently pipette the contents of the well several times to resuspend the colonies. A single cell suspension is not required, but gently dispersing the colony will promote cell proliferation. A multi-channel pipetter set at 100 microliters may be used for this purpose after all the colonies have been picked. Ensure that a new sterile pipette tip is used for each well. Grow the cells for approximately 4 days and then screen for specific protein products using appropriate screening assays. Incubation times will vary depending on the cell type. Because discrete colonies are harvested from the semi-solid medium individually, cultures that test positive for the product of interest have a high probability of monoclonality. This allows you to move on to further stages of cell line development more quickly. Semi-solid cloning with ClonaCell Media helps you take the smart way to the right clone. Visit stemcell.com for more information about ClonaCell products for CHO cells, hybridomas, and other cell lines.